So let's get started with this framework. First step in the framework is a series of caveats. So caveat, that's a fancy word for watch out. So what do you want to watch out for? So I have a friend, very successful healthcare venture capitalist, and he said, there's a difference between literature, meaning a business plan or an idea for a new venture, and life, meaning the reality of that new venture. He said literature is all romance and no children. He didn't use the word romance. You know what word he used. But life, it's all children and no romance. And he said that's the way it is with healthcare innovation. The literature, the business plan, it's full of hearts and flowers, but the reality is very hard. So how do you know what's literature and how do you know what's life? Well, one thing you should be very careful of are true believers. So true believers are the missionaries who have created this new venture, and they deeply believe in it. They're passionate about it. They're so passionate that they may not see the world the way you would see the world. So don't believe the true believers. I don't mean they're liars. Some people are, most are not. What I mean is they see the world differently from the way that you may see the world. So how do you get a reality check on the world? You need to go back to basics. So if somebody says, the market for telemedicine is $30 billion, what are you going to do with this? Well, you have to understand the basics. How many people are going to be using telemedicine? What will they be using it for? Who is actually going to pay for this? How much are they willing to pay? And you've got to do this area by area of application because the answers all differ. So right away, you know that innovating in healthcare, it's not all high-level stories. You got to get a lot of dirt under the fingernails in order to do it appropriately.